Wondering what's really happening in the real estate market right now? Well, today we're going to break down all the latest trends in the Seminole County and Central Florida area that you, as a buyer, seller, and investor, really need to know. Hey, everybody, Tim Weigel here, Watson Realty. Looking forward to be able to go over the real estate market with you. What we're going to be reviewing primarily is some of the municipalities in Seminole County. Comparing year over year for the month of October. And then, of course, diving a little bit into Orlando as well and some of the mortgage rates. So it's going to be exciting. Let me share my screen. Got you a nice little PowerPoint on here. So, again, this is as of today, is when I create everything. So we'll start out with Castleberry. This is for single family homes. So homes sold literally between year over year from 2023 to 2024, we sold 24 homes. Median sales price though went up year over year by about $7,500. So it's not a big increase, but nonetheless, it's an increase in single family homes. And then days on the market stayed the same at 24. The market, as you're going to see, is a little bit wonky year over year because we have a few things happening right now. Obviously, we've worked to get inflation, everything under control, but we also had a very heated election coming up, and things were definitely picking up in the month of October. Now, moving on with the Casper market, looking specifically at condos and townhomes now, we went from 11 homes sold to 9. The median sales price dropped from 285 to 259 in the condo townhome market. Days on the market increased from 7 to 50 days. So it's showing an increase there year over year. And you know, a lot of it's just because you're connected. People might prefer single family homes over condo townhomes, some of the astronomical fees that you got to pay in a month there. So it slowed it down a little bit. Plus, keep in mind there's not a heavy thing on there. So don't pay too much attention to the median drop in price. All that means is you had less homes, less things that's going to balance it out. Now, moving on to our next municipality, we're looking at Winter Park. So, single family homes dropped from 65 homes sold to 42. So, that's a pretty sharp decrease. However, if you look at the median sales price, it went up $61,500. So, it dropped and increased. So, it kind of shows you, even if there are less homes being sold, which is going to be an ongoing theme today for a trend. Prices are still trending up. Again, another ongoing theme. Days on the market sitting 42. Now let's move on to the condo and townhomes for Winter Park. Again, homes sold dropped from 31 to 21. So a decrease of about 33% there. But then the price of it increased $40,000. And the days on market also increased. You see where we're going with this? All right, now we move over to Winter Springs and this is single family homes. Small decrease, 41 homes to 36, but an increase in prices, 12,500. And then also increase in days on market by 12 days on market. Ta-da. Now let's move into the condo. Homes sold, 13 to 12. Did see a little bit decrease here from 275 to 259, but the days on market is still inching up. Now we move over to Oviedo market for single family homes. 58 homes sold in October of 2023, yet we take you to October of 2024, and we're now up to 45. So that's a decrease of 13. Sales price still staying around the same median wise. It actually increased slightly by about $3,750. And then days on market, a little over double at 9 days to 22 days. Now let's jump into the condo townhouse market. 20 of them sold in October of last year. Come fast forward to this year, we're down to 8. Median sales price, because I mean, you lose 12 homes into that median, you're going to potentially have a bigger drop off than normal. So dropped off to 384,250. And then days on market increased by 8. Now let's jump into the Longwood market. This is a little bit of a anomaly. 33 homes sold and then jumped up to 46. Median sales price went from 515 to 499.5. Days on market went from 13 to 32. So it's a little flip than what we've been used to seeing. Now let's take a look at the townhomes. 23 to 7, big decrease there. Then it went from 312 to 285, bigger decrease. And then the days on market increased 7 to 23. Now we're going to move into the Orlando market. So Orlando's single family home, 642 homes to 509. So that's a big jump. But the median sales price stayed the same at 440. So days on market, 17 days to 30 days. So for the most part, Orlando, which is a bigger metro area than some of these other municipalities, showing a little bit more stability on the price, but still showing less people buying because of the biggest X factor is probably the election. Now we jump into the Orlando market for condos and townhomes, 264 to 178. Again, bigger numbers, still staying about the same. Days on market doubled almost from 23 to 43. So now let's talk a little bit about the mortgage market. So as of last Friday, one of my lenders I work with let us know that the conventional rate was around 6.625%. And it's going up and going down. And there's a lot of information flying in that area. Some days we win, some days we lose with it. VA FHA is actually hovering around 5.875. This week will be another week where I think we're going to see some big changes, and it all depends on how it works. We got the jobs report coming out and the CPI. For those that don't know what the CPI is, that's called the Consumer Price Index. That's how they're rating inflation. If the inflation's going down or if it's going up, it's going to be from there. And in which direction it goes, it's going to make the market spike or decrease. Knock on wood, it's a decrease for us. Now, let's talk a little bit about my take. The market was stagnant for the last month. I mean, that's a fact. I mean, you saw this data. The prices are really not jumping up. The biggest example of it was when you look at Orlando, which had the biggest sample size, the pricing stayed literally the same. With the markets where they have less sample size, it doesn't take much to impact those median numbers. But when you take a bigger picture of it all, they all are going to come out to about the same. It's where it is slow. All year, I mean, all the big wigs, when you look at real estate, diving into the numbers, driving into the market, having your thumb on the pulse, everyone has been saying market is moving up, just slow. And that's what we're seeing. And we've seen it all year. And then moving into the election cycle, we started to see a slowdown. And the slowdown isn't because the market is bad. The slowdown is what's going to happen. I mean, when you have a divided country and a heated election, things happen that make people want to wait to see what the outcome is so they know what direction they want to move. At the end of the day, the market looks fine. So no matter who won, the market was still going to end up moving positively afterwards, just because that's the way supply and demand works when it comes to inventory. So prices are going to continue moving up. In fact, I think right now we're on the calm before the storm, because I think we're moving into 2025. That's going to symbolize a lot of what we experienced in 2020, 2021, just maybe not till that extreme. So, and then I anticipate we're going to see some unique results through this holiday. I think now, if you're a buyer and you want to buy, now is a great time because you're going to have less competition. It's going to be a lot more challenging as a buyer to get a home under contract next year because you're going to start seeing more multiple offers, more challenges. In fact, I even see some multiple offers today. But like I said on the slide, 2025 will be on fire. So, what I would recommend doing is don't sit around and wait for it to happen. Now's the time to sit down with a professional, whether it's me or someone else, and just have a conversation. Don't worry about wasting my time with conversation, because these conversations are going to save you. I hear buyers and sellers all the time, "Well, I didn't want to bother you." It's no bother. I'm going to be busy whether you're bothered, well, so-called bothering me or not, but it's my job to help you, and I want to be able to help you move forward. So, and not being prepared, especially when we have the opportunity during the holidays, is a recipe for disaster. So now, if you want to connect with me, check out the QR code. You can connect with me. Please reach out to me. I'd love to have a sit down with you, talk about your options, because I would prefer you know your options before you make a decision that's not good for you versus flying into it willy-nilly and ending up with a lot of regret. You know, people always talk about all the stresses and all the issues that they have when purchasing their home. A lot of it comes from not being fully prepared going into it and not having a plan of attack, and not wanting to talk to someone. So please talk to me, talk to anyone else, even in the real estate industry. Let's get you with a lender. Let's see what we can do to help get you in a home or an investment property, whatever you need, because I think it's going to be a great, great 2025. And now's the time to prepare for that. So if you don't prepare, you're going to have some issues. So let's connect. I'll talk to you all later. And if you have any questions, you know where to find me. Always here.